Hey, Rascal. Rascal dog. Come here. Where'd you come from? I guess Mike let you out, huh? Yeah. How alert is he? Little Johnny on the spot. He loves days like this. It's not too cold. It is cold, but it's just not too cold for him to be outside. He's just loving it out here. Me, on the other hand, I have so many pairs of layers on. It's kind of hard for me to move because I don't want to be out here in the cold. But regardless of what I want, things have to be done. And the main trimming of this tree I like to do after the growing season, when it gets really cold and the sap stops running in the tree. So today was that day. So I decided to come on out, and this is the last of the what we would call nice days of winter. The temperatures are gonna slowly start going down, the snow's gonna start falling. We've been lucky this year. Temperatures have been relatively high and the snow really hasn't fallen. This is December 30th that I'm filming this. Even though the program is going to be released in January, I want to film this now because in January, when as the next week or two comes along, we're expecting colder temperatures and snow. And the last thing I want to be is on a ladder in snow. So I'm doing this right now. Anyway, it's cold enough that the tree's sap has stopped running, and that's important for me because when I do big cuts, which is what I'm going to do on this tree, when I do big cuts, as in large branches being chopped off, I prefer to have it done when it's really, really cold. That way, less likely for fungus, bacteria, any kind of problems to affect the tree. And when it's really, really cold, the trees heal up a lot better than when they're warm. And also the sap doesn't run out. Because when the sap runs out, the sap is a bit sweet and that attracts things like flies, fungus, molds, all kinds of nasties that can harm my tree. So that's why I'm doing it in the cold. That's why I'm bearing this cold and you are too. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take you around the tree. And this is actually, I think the second, maybe third, trimming of this tree. I started when I first got here and I did the first step in the trimming, and I believe this is the second thing. The first part, when I got here, this tree was uncared for. It was just out here in the middle of nowhere, and nobody cared for it for years. It was very, very tall. It was beautiful. It was actually a picture perfect looking tree until you looked up close, and then you realize, ooh, there's issues with this tree. When I have a fruit tree, I wanna make sure that it's gonna have branches that are low enough for me to reach. I don't wanna have to use, I have an apple picker that'll reach way up there. I don't wanna have to use that. And this is an incredibly windy area, all right? And I don't like that the wind blows through in hurricane force winds, and the upper branches were swaying like this and banging the apples around. That would bruise my apples and it would also fling them off. You know, it just looked ridiculous and it was a waste of apples for me. The birds and squirrels loved it. I didn't like it so much because I wasn't getting very many apples. What I'm doing is I'm training this apple tree to grow low and out so that the wind doesn't hit it quite as hard. And it's also the practice that I do with the pepper plants and tomatoes is I prune them back. The branches get stronger, they get sturdier, they're able to hold more. And that's exactly what I'm doing here, only on a slower scale. So I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna cut, and I'm gonna explain to you why I'm cutting it. So you're gonna come along with me if you want, and we can prune this tree together. And hopefully, since it's a little breezy, my microphone, sometimes even with the windscreen, it picks that up, and I don't wanna have a wind, so I'm turning this way away from the wind. So if you do hear wind, please bear with me, okay? I'm doing the very best I can with what I have to work with. I'm gonna start off by showing you what I need to cut this year, and then we'll get to the cuts themselves, because once I start this chainsaw, I'm not turning it off, okay? I have my tools. I have a sturdy ladder. I have my pruners over here, and these are really cool. I got these as a gift for my birthday. What do you get the guy who does a lot of tree pruning? You get him some sharp pruners, because the other ones, I was just ticking the tree off. I was trying to prune that off and I was splintering everything and I was really damaging the tree more than I was helping it. So Mike the dishwasher got these for me and they're nice and sharp, and a chainsaw. I know this seems a little bit drastic. A chainsaw to prune a tree? Well, yes. When the tree has not been cared for, sometimes you have to make some big cuts because things have been neglected. So I'm gonna have to do that. Now, I want to do a disclaimer really quick before we get to this, because it's going to be relatively quick, but I want to tell you, this is how I prune my tree. I'm not giving you the definitive method on how to prune a tree, okay? That's not what I do. I really don't do anything like that. I don't tell you this is how you need to do things, because when you do something like that, you're putting yourself into the position as the authority source, and you're opening yourself up to critique of your methods, and everybody has their own methods. It's kind of like making bread. There's a million different ways to make bread, And so if I were to come out and say, this is how you make bread, this is the way you make bread, boy, I'm asking for it, and rightly so. And so what I'm telling you is, this is how I choose to prune my trees. There's a lot of different ways to do it. This is how I want to do mine. And if you have a tree that you want to grow the same way, maybe this will be a demo for you. Okay, I'm going to put my coffee away because it's really not hot coffee anymore. It's cold coffee, and I don't like cold coffee. I'm going to show you where I'm going to cut this thing, okay? Hold on just a second. Let me find a place for this. The main trunk is nice and straight. I really do like that. It started out good, but then it has this really heavy, very pronounced right fork. Now, I don't really much care for that because that puts a lot of weight on just that one side of the tree, because over half the tree was on that branch. That's not really a good thing to have so much weight pulling down on that, because when you think about it, that's a lot of tree. Now, this tree has been pruned, and it was huge when I got here, so there was even more weight. I've taken about 50% of the weight off here, so you can imagine twice the amount of weight pulling down on that just one spot right there. And let's add on the leaves, the sap that's in there that adds weight, and lots and lots of apples. And then you get a wind that moves it back and forth. That's not a good thing. So I probably wouldn't have had that fork if I would have been here when it was a younger tree. I would have had it go up and fork off of this main, this would have been a thicker main trunk, and had I would have promoted the branches coming out on the side, and that way they go straight out from the main tree. That would have been perfect, but this is not a perfect world. So now I got to deal with what I have at hand, not what I wanted. So what I'm doing is I'm promoting smaller branches. I'm trying to move the camera while I'm getting underneath the tree, so bear with me. This branch right here. Now, this the best branches that you can find on a fruit tree that bears fruit are, like, if this would be the main branch, you like the ones that are coming straight out. Now, that is the best type of forking you can have on a tree, because, see this? That's what I call the muscle. That will hold the branch a lot better than if it were to be a V, okay? So V's are not the best thing. L's are the best thing that you can have in your tree. So this one was a real light branch when I first moved here. I think it was just a real wisp of a branch. Now, I've been promoting that, and look at this, see? It's coming out, and it's gotten stronger. So that's a good strong branch. This thing up here just went nuts, and I've already trimmed off a lot of it, but I'm going to have to trim off more, because I'm trying to keep it low, like I mentioned, low to the ground, so that I can reach it without having to use a device to pick apples, and it keeps the wind off. And so I'm trying to figure out what I want to remove from this tree, from this nice branch that I mentioned. Everything above that is going to be sliced off. Now, look at that. That is a lot of tree to cut off. And like I said, this is drastic, but this is my tree, and I want to grow it the way that I want it to be grown. And I know from experience that this is going to help it in the long run. It's a tough love thing, and it's really difficult to do. And that's why I'm telling you, if you don't feel comfortable doing this with your tree, by all means, don't do it with your tree. I'm just showing you how I do mine, and then if you tune into future episodes, you're going to see what the results are. I did the big pruning. Now let me move in here. I want to show you. I took out the very center of this tree with a chainsaw last year. Those of you who were tuning in, you saw that. Look at this. I took out a huge portion of this tree. That was the entire upper story of it. And I took it off in two huge cuts. That was a huge amount. And folks were a little bit aghast. They were like, Ray, what were you thinking? Well, this last season, I had a huge amount of apples growing on the lower part, and that's exactly what I wanted. Now, the problem with that is I had too many apples, and they were huge. They were beautiful apples. So I actually got what I wanted, but I got more than what I wanted. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut more of the upper story off. But the second stage of this, I'm going to take these long, sturdy branches, and I'm going to cut the ends off of them. And that will sturdy them up and take some of the weight off the end, because the apples love to go right towards the end. And that's where they come out, is on these spurs. You'll see little spurs on here, the little pointy things. Generally, that's where your first leaves come out, and that's where a lot of your apples are going to be. Now, if you have a whole crap load of apples over here, what it's going to do is it's going to pull that down. And I don't like that. I had people tell me, Ray, you could just take a broomstick or any kind of stick and prop it up. Well, you know what? I don't want my tree trussed up. I want my tree to be able to hold its production without me having to assist it with crutches. I don't like that idea, because if it's unable to hold itself up, then I'm not doing my job to strengthen my tree. That's why I'm going to be cutting it. Now that I've explained what I'm going to do, let's fire up the old machinery and let's get it done. He loves this. This is the perimeter of the yard right by the apple trees. And when I come out here, he goes out there and he pushes himself through this grass, this old dried grass, and these bushes out here, because there's rabbits hiding out here. And they hold perfectly still until he's right on him. And then all of a sudden, rabbits just come bursting out of here. And he loves that. He chases them. He can never catch them. I mean, come on. He's crackhead. He's not a roadrunner. And he can't catch them, but he just loves messing with them. And they're in no danger from this little guy. But he keeps busy. That's a good thing. He keeps himself busy. He doesn't sit out here and whine because it's cold. He's a tough little bugger. Ah, what the heck. Cold coffee is better than no coffee. Okay, I was wrong. I was wrong. Okay, cold coffee is not better than no coffee. Anybody that tells you that is not your friend. All right, let's get the tools ready. I got the chainsaw. I'm going to start with the chainsaw and cut the main parts off. And then I'm going to work my way down to the pruners and cut all the little saplings that are left over. Now, let's see. I'm going to take off my glove to do this, but then I want to put my gloves on. Now, I don't do this when there's nobody around. Mike the dishwasher is home today. I don't operate any kind of dangerous machinery or get up on the roof or climb trees when there's nobody here. I'm a little bit crazy, but I'm not stupid. And I want to make sure that there's safety here, okay? Because theoretically, if I hurt myself, I could be laying out here dying and there's nobody to hear me. I have no neighbors within earshot of me. So, what would I do when Mike's gone all day long? I could actually be in danger. So I make sure that Mike's here, he knows what I'm doing, and that way if there's ever an issue, I'm safe. So make sure, safety first, okay? It's all fun and games until Ray falls out of the tree. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, get the gas going, I got the choke on. All right, everybody, cross your fingers because chainsaws, you never know if they're gonna start or not. And Rascal hates chainsaws too. He'll come barking at it, but I won't let him too close to it. All right. Ha! Thank you very much. Okay. It's got a safety guard. The chain won't move until you pull this back. Kind of cool, huh? And you hold on to this. Kind of keeps you from pulling your leg up. Okay, all joking aside, this is where I needed to make the cut. Now, I don't want to cut this, otherwise the whole thing could fall and break other branches. So I have to take it off in pieces. All right. There's one. And you know, this doesn't go to waste. I hope you can hear me. This doesn't go to waste. The goats love apple branches. So I'm gonna take the smaller branches, prune them off, and feed them to the goats. They're gonna love that. And also, I put them in my wood pile over there. You can't see it, but it is over there. I have deer that come through my yard. And hopefully they'll stop and eat the little branch tips, because deer love apple trees. They'll eat the branch tips and not come all the way over here. I'm thinking ahead. Okay, one branch is off. Here's the cut. This needs to come off too. So, don't go nowhere. Oh, that was a little too easy. Okay, now I want to make sure I make a good clean cut. That is the thing that you'll want to make sure. You don't want to be chopping away at things. When you're doing trees, you want to make sure you have a good clean cut. That is beautiful. That's a good cut. See, I have no bark stripped off the side from a bad cut. This is nice and clean. The bark ends right where the wood was cut. That's what I want. And oh, the smell. You know, apple wood smells really wonderful. And another thing is, if you have an old tree and you're cutting it up, you may want to save those pieces of apple wood, cut them into discs, and you can put this in your barbecue and when you're barbecuing the next year, and the apple wood smoke is wonderful for barbecuing. It is fantastic. I've done that before. Apple wood makes a great wood for burning. Okay, the next cut was going to be right here to take off this huge thing. There is no need to have this. Even though I have some branches coming down, I have this one that I've been training for a couple years. So I need to get this one out of here. Now, like this one that was right here, if I cut the whole thing off, it's gonna come crashing into here and it may damage those. So I'm gonna start with the end and work my way down. That's the safest way to do it. Oh, beautiful. Hey, look at me go. And you know, it's something that you can do with your family too. Get the kids out here. Get them away from their PlayStations. Get them out here and have them haul some of these branches away. This is a family thing. Okay, now this last cut is really close to here. I have to be very careful not to go too fast, because if I go too fast, or you, if you're doing this, you can fly through this and nick the other branch. That's a bozo no-no. Remember bozo no-nos. Oh, that's beautiful. Wow, really does open it up, doesn't it? And that's what I want to do. I wanted to get all that garbage out from above, and that way the sun can just shine down and warm these up and give them all the light that they need to produce the big, strong leaves and delicious sweet apples. Huh. Oh, this is going beautifully, a lot faster than I thought. Yes, it's not beautiful, but then again, it's not a prom queen, folks. It's an apple tree, and I'm doing the very best that I can to give it the very best care that I can. Now, I want to show you something that is something that you'll probably run into with one of your trees. You may not have these huge branches that are in your way, because you'll probably take better care of your tree than whoever used to live here. But here's a common problem. You can see how these branches are coming out. This is a really nice branch. This is a nice branch. They have a little bit of separation. That's good, because when the leaves fill out, this is gonna fill in. If they're too close together, they're gonna rub together, and they're gonna have apples there too. So picture that. It's gonna be a lot fuller. Here's another V. This is beautiful. That's exactly what we want. We want some space in between these. We don't want them all clustered. Oops, here we go. Here's the problem child. This is a clustered looking branch. It has too much going on over here. Now, this looks bad, and it is bad for a couple reasons. You got too much right here, all right? So what we're gonna have to do is, there's a black mark right there. I'm gonna take this off, this middle one. This will open up that. That takes care of that problem. The second problem is, farther down, there's a branch that comes out and it goes up and it goes over. That sucks. That is up to no good. It's cluttering things up. And you also have a branch right above a branch. That's not a good thing, because it's gonna be pushing stuff down, and it's going to be cluttering up the joint. So that one's got to come off as well. I just wanted to mention that to you, because that might be a common issue. Branches should not cross, and they should not lay on top of one another. If you ever see that, one of them has to go. Okay, the first one will be right here. Perfect. a beautiful cut on this. Now, I want to show you something because Ray is not perfect. If I was, I'd be making more money. I was coming down to cut this and just the momentum flying through here. Look at this. I did a little nick right here. That is not a problem. A little nick like that will heal over. The green part will seal over. If you're worried about this, what you can do, put a little bit of Vaseline on there and then take an ace bandage and wrap it semi-snug and then close it up and leave it like that for the rest of the winter. And then once the leaves come out on the trees and everything's green, remove that ace bandage, you're gonna have no problem whatsoever.
Hey, Lewis.
Hear that? I hope you can hear that. That's Lewis way over there. He can't see me, but he knows I'm out here because I'm talking and he calls to me. Lewis is very, very bonded to me. Anyway, back to this. I'm going to go around here and I'm probably not going to film that because it just takes a while. And I'm going to spend some quality time with just me and Rascal on this tree. But you can see on the top of this tree, these tall, thin branches coming up. That's not what I want. Those do not need to be there because all that's going to do is eventually they're going to have apples and they're going to want to go like this. And then I'm back to square one. Those ones I'm going to prune all the way back to the main branch. It's an ongoing thing, and I want to explain that to you. When you start pruning an apple tree, this is a lifelong commitment. You have to continue to prune this thing. That's just what you're in for, okay? This is maintenance. This isn't one of those things where you prune it and it's done. No, that's not how things work, okay? The reality is you're always gonna have to take off branches that are not growing in the direction that you want them to grow. I don't want anything growing up, so I'm gonna go through there and do that off camera. I'm gonna prune off all that little top fuzz. Those are called water sprouts, and basically all they are is branches that come up from the excess energy stored up in the tree after you prune it. You'll always see all these branches coming up. Well, you're gonna have to face it. Keep pruning those things off, and that'll take the energy off of those, and also with the big ones we cut, and force it down to here, and these ones will get stronger. And so right here, what happened is this branch, the side of the tree, produced so many apples last year, and I'm not kidding, I showed a program on this, and this branch was actually on the ground, and I didn't want to pick all the apples off of it to get it off the ground because they were beautiful, and but what was happening is squirrels and mice were taking nibbles off of it, and also I couldn't get underneath here to mow the grass underneath the tree. And so I wanted to make sure that this didn't happen again, okay? Because it's a waste of apples as far as I'm concerned. I like to feed the wildlife, but you know what? There should be some for me too, because I'm the one doing all the work. And all of this is an investment for me, for the future. I'm thinking if I keep pruning this tree, long after I'm gone, whoever owns this farm after me, they're gonna be enjoying apples because of what I did to correct the growth of this tree. So what I wanna do is I wanna cut off the tips of these. I'm gonna be taking off a lot of potential apples, but then again, like I say, I'm in it for the long haul. Now I gotta figure out what do I wanna take off? This branch right here is a long sloping branch. I'm gonna wanna take about half of that off. And there is no exact science to this. Some people may say there is, I claim there is not. I'm just taking off about half the branches from the fork here, and that's gonna lighten up the load just a little bit. This one I don't have to worry about yet. Maybe next year I'll cut it halfway down. Not necessary this year. These water sprouts up here, those really are never gonna serve a purpose. They're just gonna keep going up, and that's gonna be a bad thing. So what I'm gonna do is prune those. Now when you prune a little branch off, you wanna prune it about maybe a finger's width from the main branch. You don't want to prune it right up against there, about a finger's width, and leave that there. That'll help seal it up, because if you take it too close to the little branch here, there's a chance that it could damage the main branch. See what I'm saying? Okay, now this one, snip. It's kind of like giving you a haircut. You get all the main crap off, and then you go back and you trim up around the neck and stuff. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm just trimming up a little bit off the perimeters. But in a nutshell, now this one, this has no business being here, okay? Bye-bye. But basically, this is done. This is what it looks like when you prune an apple tree. And I'm gonna set this aside for now and find Rascal so that we can sign off. Hold on right there, he's around here somewhere. Rascal! Did you get everything? Well, I hope you had a good time with the trimming of the tree. If you have any questions concerning your fruit trees, how to care for them, anything at all, please feel free to post a comment in the comment section below, and I will answer your questions as soon as possible. This little tree back here, oh no, you're not going yet. We're not done. This little tree back here in this fenced area, I got it all trussed up and fenced up to protect it from the deer, because the younger ones are more susceptible to massive damage that could harm them in the future than these large ones. The large ones can come back a lot easier than the little ones. So I'm going to be showing you how I pruned this little teeny tiny one. I don't know what kind this is. This was here when I got here, and it has grown since I moved in. Now I'm going to be pruning this as well, probably starting next year, but I think I'm pretty much done for now. I know, I want to go too. We're going to go run around and chase things, but thank you for joining me. I really do appreciate it. Stay warm, everybody. All right, let's go, baby. It's funny. Could be anything, huh?